Shankar Basu just said on one of the days when he came for the press conference that, you know, he's seeing a 2.0 version, really, of Mohammed Shami. He's a different man when it comes to his fitness, his, you know, the regime that he follows. And you're looking at it in the way he's giving results, which we've seen not just in test matches, but also in ODIs. For him, what would this moment be like that he comes in now and plays this game?
I think from India's point of view, the real positive is Meha, he will be ready. You can be assured of that, because of the players that India have picked in the squad are all players that can anticipate playing in the 11 at the drop, as soon as an opportunity arises. Sure. And I think Shami would have been in the thoughts of the team management, but for what happened in the first game against South Africa, when the wrist spinner started to do well in tandem, and that's when Shami's chances of playing in the 11 receded, because India saw the value, even in England, of these wrist spinners operating in the middle overs. I think he will do a more than adequate job. He has added a little bit of pace. I'm sure Rohan has noticed that as well. He's bowling a lot quicker. I think he'll use the new ball well if the conditions are overcast. Afghanistan's batting has been shambolic. And in that way, it's a great opportunity, Meha, because at the end of the day, if he puts up figures, 5 for 15, 5 for 20, 25, then he makes an even more compelling case to stay on in the 11, even if Bhuvneshwar comes back. Sure. So I think these are the kinds of things that he will be looking out for. If India bowl first and it's a bit overcast, watch out, Afghanistan.